This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome on this, the fifth Sunday of Easter. Also, here in the United States, we observe and we celebrate Mother's Day. I would like to at this time wish all mothers a very blessed Mother's Day. During this service this morning, we will honor and recognize two of St. Thomas' mothers, the oldest mother of our church, 107 years old, and also the newest and the youngest mother of St. Thomas' Church. Let us now prepare our hearts for a joyous worship. Hallelujah! Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah. On this day, the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it. My brothers and sisters, let us now kneel, if you are able, and confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded it. The dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord, our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
A reading from Psalm 31, verses 1 through 5, 15 through 16. In you, O Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Incline your ear to me. Make haste to deliver me. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. For you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me. Take me out of the net that they have secretly set for me, for you are my tower of strength. Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Make your face to shine upon your servant, and in your loving kindness, save me.
If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Jesus said to the disciples, you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to Jesus, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to Thomas, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to Jesus, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to Philip, have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask for anything, I will do it. If in my name you ask for anything, I will do it. The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus said, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe in me also. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Our appointed gospel lesson for this morning, the fifth Sunday of Easter, being the observance of Mother's Day here in these United States. This gospel offers us a deep reminder, deep reassurance, a deep reaffirmation of our faith. At the beginning of the gospel, Jesus speaks these words to a few of his disciples. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe in me also. He goes on to spiritually speak of and describe his heavenly plan and place of departure. And he tells them, you know the way to the place where I am going. One of the disciples immediately responded, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we possibly know the way? Jesus then responded with these words. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And if you know me, you know the Father. He went on to explain to them what it means to actually know him. On this blessed Mother's Day, I want to take a few moments to remind us that our hearts need not be troubled or overwhelmed by the troubles of this world. Or in the words of that old Negro spiritual, soon I'll be done with the trouble of the world. No more weeping, no more wailing. Church, soon, and very soon, there will be no more suffering, no more illness, no more sadness, no more worries. Why? Because we know that God is still in control. God is still in control. God is still in control. I don't know about you, but it was my dear mother, my dear deceased mother, who at a very early age instilled and planted in me a strong and deep spiritual faith, a deep spiritual faith that said that no matter what obstacles or what struggles or what troubles or what hills or what mountains you may face in life, that you should always remember that God is in control. God is still in control. This Mother's Day morning, as we still find ourselves yet into another month of walking down pandemic road, I am first reminded of our gospel lesson a few weeks ago when Jesus joined two disciples on their walk to Emmaus. And I am further reminded this morning of my mother's teaching, my mother's testimony that God is still in control and that he's got the whole world in his hands. That he's got the whole world in his hand. That he's got this whole pandemic world in his hands. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, let not your hearts be troubled, but continue to believe in God. Believe in God's amazing grace and amazing mercy. Believe in God's omniscience, omnipresence, omnipotence. Believe in the power and the strength of prayer. Believe in the holy word of God. Believe that he's got the whole world, the whole pandemic world in his hands. He's got all of God's children in his hands. He's got the moon and the stars in his hands. He's got the wind and the clouds in his hands. He's got the rivers and the mountains in his hands. He's got the oceans and the seas in his hands. He's got the sun and the rain in his hands. He's got the doctors and the scientists and the researchers in his hands. He's got the answers and the solutions and the cures to this pandemic in his hands. For a brief moment, let us now recognize two of St. Thomas' mothers who are indeed living testimonies of what it means to walk by faith and not by sight. Who knows what it means to say God is still in control. First, we will hear from our newest, and not only our newest, but actually our youngest mother of St. Thomas Church. And pardon me if I pronounce her name wrong, but her first name is Oni, and her last name is Wenashi Shudo, or something like that. Let us hear now from our dear mothers.
Dear St. Thomas, it is a great privilege to speak to you today as a new mom of St. Thomas. It is an amazing and an exciting feeling to be a new mom. Children are a priceless gift from God, and they have been entrusted into our care, and it is our responsibility as mothers to take good care of our children and to guide them rightly. To all the mothers out there, as we go through this journey of motherhood, it is paramount to be steadfast in faith. Certain situations might arise, but with God, we will get through it all. So as we perform our duties as mothers, let us also remember to take good care of ourselves. Eat healthy, stay fit, and raise godly children. To all mothers of St. Thomas and mothers all over the world, a wonderful, happy Mother's Day to you all. You are blessed and highly favored. God bless you and stay safe. Bye.
Thank you, Oni. And to God be the glory for that rich testimony that you shared as the newest and youngest mother of our church family. And now we will hear from our oldest member of St. Thomas Church, 107 years young. 107 years young. To God be the glory for the things he has done. Ruth Hobson. Ruth Hobson. She could not be with us this morning, but her lovely daughters sat with her this week and they jotted down some important testimonial points that she wanted to share with you this morning. And that testimony will be shared and narrated by our own Ashley Williams, who is also a new mother of St. Thomas Church. Actually, her child was born 1 month before Oni's son was born. Let us now hear Ashley as she narrates the words of our 107-year-old member of our church family, Ruth Hobson.
Happy Mother's Day. It is my honor this Mother's Day to read a letter from the oldest mother of St. Thomas Church, Ruth Hobson. It is a blessing and an honor to be the oldest mom of St. Thomas Church. I have so many wonderful memories of my St. Thomas family. Everyone at church has been so good to me over the years, keeping me in their thoughts and prayers. No matter your age, every mother enjoys the love and appreciation of her family. My advice for all new mothers is to keep your faith, family, and friends close to your heart. Be mindful of your values in all you do. Teach your children to become good Christians. I was born in 1912, just a few years before the epidemic of 1918. Although I was just a child, I heard others talk about it. Things have changed, yet things are still the same. As mothers, we will always worry about our children and their future, especially during this pandemic. So much is beyond our control. We need to do as much as we can to keep our children safe. We have always relied on our faith and trust in the Lord to see us through hard and difficult times. We need our faith now more than ever. Have faith that things will be good again. As mothers, we share so much in common. The love for our children brings us so much joy. It is in this spirit that I wish all the mothers of St. Thomas God's blessing for a happy Mother's Day. And that again was from Ruth Hobson, the oldest mother of St. Thomas Church. And to you, Ruth, a blessed and beautiful happy Mother's Day. And to all the moms, grandmothers, godmothers of St. Thomas Church.
reaffirm our faith by saying together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us now pray in the words our Savior taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them, now and always. Day by day, we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and your mercy. We put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. Almighty God, whom truly to know is everlasting life, grant us so perfectly to know your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the way, the truth, and the life, that we may steadfastly follow his steps in the way that leads to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. At this time, I invite your personal intercessions. You may feel free to type those prayer requests and intercessions and words of thanksgiving on the Facebook post, if that's how you are viewing us this morning. Let us now pray for our personal needs. Remember, especially this morning and each day, those who are affected and infected with COVID-19, we continue to pray for them and their loved ones. We continue to pray for all medical professionals who are ministering to their needs. And certainly this morning, we pray for all of our church members who have lost loved ones. Anita Smith, William Smalls, are there others? Lynette Dickerson. We pray for their loved ones who have departed this life. May they rest in peace, and may they rise in glory. Amen. And now we close with the prayer of Saint Chrysostom. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord. Make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and the age to come, life everlasting. Before granting this morning's blessing, the names of those departed ones are Gwendolyn Smalls, sister of William Smalls, Betty Young, mother-in-law of Anita Smith, and Lynn Dickerson, father of Lynette Dickerson. Again, I want to wish all of you a safe and blessed week. And to our mothers, I wish you a most blessed Mother's Day. We give thanks again to our oldest member of St. Thomas Church, 107 years old, Ruth, and our youngest and newest mother of St. Thomas, Oni. And now, my brothers and sisters, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and forever. Amen. My brothers and sisters, let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.